for the last 5 days, Tamil Nadu has been seeing an average of more than 1,000 cases across the state, and Chennai in particular has been getting the maximum number of cases, the bulk of it. And authorities say this is mainly due to a ramped up testing, particularly in 6 clusters across Chennai, which continue to witness increasing numbers. And they attribute 15% of people here do not wear masks, and that's a major challenge. They say the numbers would continue to increase at least for another 2 weeks, because they are reaching out for a door-to-door screening and also reaching out to all street vendors and grocery shopkeepers in these areas, besides what they call coconing the elderly people to make sure they are given advanced treatment so that they don't become, they don't contract the virus. At the moment, yesterday alone, over the last 24 hours, 1,384 people have tested positive. The total positive tally active at the moment in the state remains around 12,000. Total number of cases, positive cases so far, has crossed 27,000. Chennai alone accounts for 1,072 cases over the last 24 hours, and the total active tally is 9,066. Total positive so far is at 9,459. And I spoke to the special nodal officer for Chennai, Dr. J. Radhakrishnan, who is also the Tamil Nadu Relief Commissioner. He denies there is a shortage of beds in Chennai, but accepts the system has to be streamlined to make it smoother. And this is what he had to say.
Ultimately, the behavioral change is missing. And 10 to 15% of people who actually are putting everybody else into risk. Yesterday we tested 5,700 cases, 6,600 cases in Chennai alone. So why we test is that that's the strategy the epidemiologist and medical teams have been telling, is that you need to intensify test, identify people who are avoiding test so that you can track. So they are saying that don't worry more about the numbers. Having 1,000 or even up to 1,500 cases or 2,000 cases a day is not more important, as long as the test is focused. And but breaking the cycle by getting them out and also testing their contacts. But definitely we would also like to come down. Though the active cases is not really climbing up, it is sort of not necessarily plateauing, but with a very low slope. But our concern is even this number should come down organically, right, not by reducing testing.
And sir, is there a pressure on beds available at government hospitals in Chennai? For example, we have around 5,000 beds, but there are 8,000 active cases.
No. See, I'll divide it. Right. Actually, what happens is Government of India has also given very clear guidelines. You have beds in GH. Roughly 4,900 beds. We have roughly private hospitals have offered around 4,500 beds. Plus, we have another 3,000 bed in health centers. That is, you know, serious cases go to GH. Mild cases, they get to handle. They are roughly around another 2,000 odd beds are there in that place. Plus, we have COVID care centers, you know, 2,960 beds are in health centers. Plus, COVID care centers are, we have activated centers where, you know, asymptomatic people under same medical supervision can be. That is roughly 17,000 beds we have kept it ready. Plus, people having individual toilets and having the facility to keep away, they, certain people also opt for home quarantine under medical supervision, who are tracked on a regular basis. So technically, while we always cannot, you know, in a health scenario predict at present, there is a only thing is there are certain logistical challenges that in the beginning of the day, so that people don't go around. There are 10 screening centers where they screen. Some go to COVID care center, some go to the hospital, and some go back to home quarantine. So that streamlining has to be done. And